In 2001, three women who worked at hedge funds in New York had an idea. Why not create a larger group of senior female investment professionals so they could support each other and share ideas, basically help one another? And that's how the group 100 Women in Finance was born, which almost 20 years later has 15,000 members around the world. I'm delighted to have one of the co-founders here with me today, Carol Kim, and she's also a senior managing director at Blackstone. Carol, welcome.
Thank you, Mallika.
It's really good to have you with us. And Carol, I wanted to ask you, what was it like working on Wall Street 20 years ago?
Well, first of all, it was very early, and I was very young in my career at the time. Myself and my co-founders, Dana Hall and Sarah Dyer, as you mentioned in your introduction, we were starting out in our careers in hedge funds. We were the only female in our respective firms at the time. And what we really lacked was a peer network at our own internal organizations. So we decided to create our own network outside of our own firms with people like us, women like us, that were in similar types of roles in hedge funds. And the three of us would get together regularly to share information, exchange ideas, and it was really helpful for us in developing our careers and excelling at our jobs at the time.
So you were the only women in your departments?
At our firms.
At the firms?
Yes.
So give us a sense, I mean, how big were they? How many people, how many men and one woman?
So these were small independent hedge funds at the time. So these were smaller firms to begin with. We were the only women at our respective firms. And so, like I said, we lacked a peer network of other women doing our similar types of role at our respective firms. So we were each in marketing roles at our firms. We would get together, share ideas, share information, and it was very helpful for us. And so one day we decided, let's expand our network. Let's send an email out to all the women we know also working at hedge funds in New York at the time. Let's organize a networking event to get together and expand this network that's working well and helping us. We did that. 60 women showed up at this networking event.
And you weren't expecting that many?
We weren't expecting, and another 40 contacted us and said, great idea. Let us know the next time you get together.
So
we'd
there
love
you had
to get
it,
together.
60 and 40, you had your 100 women in finance.
It was
right there.
That's how we came up with the name 100 Women in Hedge Funds
so
at the time.
So you obviously hit on something because there was a need for it if you had 100 women like that.
Yes.
And what was the biggest challenge you all faced at that time? Or when you got together and women, you discuss, you know, issues, what was the biggest challenge back then that the 100 of you faced, and how has it changed over the course of 20 years?
Well, I think the biggest challenge was, like I said, just having a peer, another professional woman that we could talk to, maybe kind of create a safe environment outside of our own respective firms that we can bounce ideas, ask questions, and learn from one another. And just know that other women like us existed in the industry. When we created this platform, it helped us and the industry more broadly realize that there are women in the industry, and it helped us to support each other and lean on one another and then get the support from other leading men in the industry, which was very critical and pivotal in helping us get to that next level.
I'm going to come back to the leading men and the male allies topic in just a moment, but there are more women in finance now than there were 20 years ago, but not enough. And there is a big focus on women in leadership roles, you know, right at the top of companies, C-suite roles. But Sheryl Sandberg said something quite interesting when she spoke at the Year Ahead Summit in New York. Let's listen to what she said.
I think a lot of our diversity efforts are focused on the C-suite, on getting women at the top. The problem is that if you have 100 men and 72 women at the first manager level, you've basically lost the battle at the top right from there, because those are the people that you can pick from to get promoted to director. So as much as we need to focus on top leadership, we have to go younger and or earlier in the careers and focus on that broken step.
So Sheryl Sandberg talks about the importance of the middle layer. Your reaction?
I couldn't agree more. at the time, this is just like what we were thinking at 100 Women in Hedge Funds. In fact, in some ways, we were that emerging middle layer at the time in our own careers. And we needed to see some people. There's been a lot of emphasis on that C-suite, and I think it's great. There's also similarly been a lot of emphasis on the pipeline and building the pipeline and having more, that next generation, having more women enter the industry in the first place. I think it's great that we're working on this pipeline, but this great pipeline of women that we're introducing into the industry, they need to be able to see, have a role model just a couple of rungs ahead of them.
Right.
Maybe the C-suite is a few rungs too high, and maybe a little bit unrelatable. It's helpful to have someone that's a little bit more relatable to them, and that's very important. I see it at Blackstone as well. Mm-hmm. We've had in the last 3 years in Asia for Blackstone, for example, the number of women in principal and managing director positions in our investment and investor relations roles has doubled. Mm-hmm. And the number of women that we've brought in at the analyst level has really increased from 15% in 2015 to 40% in 2019.
That's an encouraging jump.
It's very encouraging. And we expect that number to increase to 45% in our 2020 analyst class. So it's really about investing in that next generation, widening the funnel of talent of women coming into the industry, but not neglecting that middle rung, because all this great investment that you're making in the next generation, in the future, we need to provide relatable support for those women. And right. I completely agree with what Sheryl Sandberg is saying and the importance of that middle rung.
And very quickly, one last question for you. Recently, I've spoken to some women who have said they don't need male allies. And the feeling is, you know what? Talking about male support and male champions undermines me. Aren't I good enough the way I am? And I was curious what your take was on that. Do men need to be part of the solution?
Absolutely, because sometimes they're part of the issues and the challenges that women faced inadvertently may be created by men. So involving men in the process, in the dialogue, and building their awareness of the challenges and the issues that women face in the industry enables them to really be part of the solution. And there are so many great men in our industry that care deeply and really believe in this issue and want to be a support and resource and help.